Some of you would hate that I would even humor the thought of bringing this project into conversation with what we're about to look at, but you have to understand the context of how I'm looking at this going in. I've been trying to cover some Christmas projects, especially lately, because it is the Christmas season after all. I'm catching up on a lot. And I have gotten behind, but I've certainly heard, with presence, there's at least one particular Christmas film being thrown around right now in a lot of the trades and on social media, that being Santa Incorporated. I just saw the trailer. I can absolutely understand with 100% certainty why that is not faring too well in the public eye. I can certainly agree. I would never watch that. And it's a bit of an irritating project. So, as I said in that video, whereas, that project, it was like venting under the mask of comedy on very, seems hot button issues and with real crass humor. And it seems, again, a bit of a vindictiveness. It would have been better, perhaps if you feel upset during the Christmas season about whatever's going on, to find a more creative outlet to turn that anger into something more edifying. That's what I'm doing here. I'm going to try to let the past die and watch a better Christmas project to get myself more, hopefully, where I would want to be in the mood of the Christmas season. Not where Santa Incorporated put me. So this is called 8-Bit Christmas, and unlike that of her project, let's even not start referring to it by name anymore. I have heard some really good things about this one. It seems this is getting a good response. At least I saw one review online from somebody I follow. I think it was on Twitter that said that I think it's her. I'll cite it if it's not. Maybe I'll try to cite and find the tweet or whatever example it was. But I remember reading a tweet from somebody that I follow. She liked it. So I've heard some good things, at least from circles that I'm in. I understand that Neil Patrick Harris is in this. He's a pretty big name. And it's another Christmas show. Who doesn't love Christmas programming? Especially when you have streaming services now trying to get into the long, game that's been on broadcast channels. For example, like with 25 Days of Christmas, notably on Freeform, you've had all those Christmas movies, running one after the other, all the novelties. And maybe we can add in 8-Bit Christmas to the mix now. Streaming's getting a little broader in its reach and coverage. So let's see what makes this film a must-see, and perhaps, again, maybe what distinguishes it from other projects. Because, Christmas projects sometimes tend to run together, especially if you're a Hallmark movie. Let's go ahead and take a look at the synopsis. This is according to IMDb. In 1980 Chicago, a 10-year-old sets out on a quest to get the Christmas gift of his generation, the latest and greatest video game system, every kid's dream. I don't know what it would be. Oh, it's a Nintendo. That's what's in the poster. And it's from the studio that brought you Elf, another Christmas novelty. Let's go ahead and take a look at how the project is. That sounds interesting. Sounds fun. Again, very relevant, I'm sure, to many kids. I wonder if Neil Patrick Harris is like playing up the grown-up version. And he's matched up, I guess, with some kid, maybe, that's playing him in the younger days. Again, the past. Yes, that's right. So he's playing the character of Jake Doyle as an adult, while Winslow Fegley is playing him as a kid. All right. Let's go ahead and take a look at the show and see, how strong of a Christmas release this is. Again, I've heard some good things, so let's see. We're going to go ahead and watch this first, and I'll talk about it more in my condensed review segment. Fawn's watching the video together. Okay, a good Christmas project, unlike that preceding one. I don't ever want to refer to name again. Okay, here we go. Let's not give it any more recognition. Let's talk about 8-Bit Christmas instead, hopefully.
Every kid, it's filmed like an old home movie. Gift they want more than anything for Christmas. This is the story of mine.
Bookends? Baseballs on them. I see that.
No, not those. Nintendo. A maze of rubber wiring and electronic intelligence.
Look at the light
so
show.
Advanced, it was deemed not a video game, but an 8-bit entertainment system.
No Nintendo on my house.
I second that.
Looks like a no-go on Nintendo.
Ah! You got the cruel siblings.
I needed a Christmas miracle.
I'm gonna rub it in your face. You have to treat me like family.
Or was it 88?
Boys, you get the Super lecture Bowl from the parents.
Does it really matter, Dad?
Okay. The year was the late 80s. I was 11 years old.
Did you wear a helmet?
Yeah, we always wore helmets in the 80s.
This is totally the same style as like bedtime stories.
Just to play one.
That's great.
Huddle masses, wanna play? What have you brought me?
Traceable
cash money.
It's the final countdown. I normally don't care for that song. I know a lot of people do. Hey, it's in spirit of the project.
This,
it's a good match.
This is bigger than Christmas. This is sour Vietnam.
I don't think that means what you think it means.
Well, for kids, you know, it might have that magnitude.
So much trouble.
Sometimes during Christmas,
he obviously really wants that.
All hope is lost. Something magical.
The biggest, you know, atrocious historical events.
Sold out in 20 minutes. Suddenly, one woman punched her grandma right in the throat. Same family, too.
Christmas can be cruel, too.
Are you making all this up?
No way.
Did you guys hear in the race selling contest? First prize is a brand new Nintendo Entertainment System.
I'm gonna kill you.
Hold on.
I like the spirit of this. It definitely is very much in line with
Nintendo's mind.
Maybe it's kind of like its own thing.
What do you want?
Wanna buy a wreath?
Ma! This kid thinks your wreath sucks!
Video games have been doing all kinds of strange things to children.
Oh no!
What?
It was the 80s. Stuff got real.
Red Dog, this is Bluebird.
This is Rambo 1.
What happened to Red Dog?
I changed it.
We're allowed to change names now. This is Millennium Falcon, super cool.
Woo! Love it.
Rated PG.
See, it's, well, it really helps everything that's being told of kids, and it has an interesting style to it. Of course, you know, a lot of it has to go to Neil Patrick Harris's acting. He's a fabulous actor. He certainly brings in a very endearing performance, and it definitely fits, I think, with the family vibe. I mean, it's fun. It's, I mean, he's got his, I guess, his daughter here. Maybe it's just one character. Maybe there's a couple more. I'm not exactly sure. But it looks fun all around. I mean, again, it has that feeling of Christmas joy that we would so often attribute, right, to a Christmas movie project. And that, you know, we've come to expect over the many years we've had special Christmas projects. Let's see if there's anything else I want to pick out. I mean, again, there is a vibe to it where there is an element of familiarity. But it is its own thing. I mean, again, that is very funny. To see, like, the magnitude of kid will go. But they really want, you know, again, the Nintendo system. I mean, how many kids, especially, didn't they, like, start making that again? Like, they put that back into modern production so you get one maybe if you didn't have one as a kid, like me? Oh, yeah, I had friends of it. I'm sure loved these toys. Now, I wasn't born, though, in the 80s. So this is probably perhaps for the adults in the room, adults older than me from a different generation, a little more memorable because you obviously had a first-hand account of, I guess, how often these items, or the console was sought after. And even, you know, in the mix of potentially getting ever customers out of your way. I mean, that'd be kind of funny. It's just like Black Friday joy from shopping. Yeah, that's always fun. I mean, you know, granted, there's been some brutal things. I mean, people have even died horrifically from, like, Black Friday, but I've never heard any stories about people being thrown off the escalator head first. Ouch. Obviously, these people that really want Nintendo, that, you know, they're willing to throw away. There's a great song about that, too. It's on YouTube. Who put it out? I think it's Rusty Cage. He put out the Black Friday song. So funny with, like, all these clips. Yeah, Black Friday is interesting. Really, like, the entire Christmas shopping season. You really want stuff. You know, every customer's getting your way. It's like hell on earth happens. It's World War III at your local mall. And people might die. it can get horrific. Well, at least, you know, people get, you know, really bruised and beaten up. I've seen so many episodes of that over the years. I mean, there's that one comic I keep flowing back to in my head of, like, oh yeah, I remember, you know, that little girl, like, all these people. This one little girl and her mom had gotten these, I think they were like crock pots or something, and some woman came over, ripped them out of the daughter's hand, and then went after the mom, and, you know, it became this screaming fit. And I'm looking at the video going, she's trying to pull out these crock pots from the mom and the daughter. There's a whole pile of crock pots that this crowd of people just ran into. You think that she could just go grab one or two off the floor? People do weird things. I mean, the holiday season is supposed to be like a time of joy, but it sometimes unleashes the crazy. and you are seeing that on display. Hey, it's fun. I mean, it makes for a very fun Christmas project, and I can certainly see why, perhaps, again, for people that are in my circles, why that was the general takeaway from the show, is just that spirit of joy and fun right in a Christmas project that a Christmas project should have, unlike that preceding one. What are your guys' thoughts with 8-Bit Christmas? I think I'll definitely watch that. Feel free to let me know your thoughts down below. Don't forget all the good stuff, like, subscribe, and sharing that bell until I get to watch more from perhaps HBO Max in the way of Christmas stuff, or whatever, you know, Christmas projects we get to watch together next on this channel. I will see them. Until that point, thanks for watching this video. I love you guys. Don't forget to love yourself, your fellow man. God bless. Peace.